Welcome back to my channel. In case you are new to my channel, you are welcome. This is Obac Tutors, educational YouTuber based in Nigeria. In this video, we'll be considering another example of non-linear data structure, which is graph. Please stay tuned. So I just said graph is an example of a non-linear data structure. That can be used to model computer network. In the simplest term, you can say that graph is the collection of nodes and edges. So we can say the simplest term, is a collection of nodes, and edges. So it's a collection of nodes and edges. So it's important for us also at this point to understand various categories of this graph can be. So the graph can fall into four major categories. Number one, categories. Undirected. Unweighted. Number two we have is undirected. Unweighted. Weighted graph. Number three we have is directed and weighted graph. And the last one among the list we have is directed and weighted graph. So this is the four major categories that this a graph can be. Now, let's look at each of them one after the other. So the first one is undirected. Unweighted. As we were told that the graph is a collection of nodes and edges. So let's say we have A, B, C, and D. So these are the nodes, while these divide this. So you can see the collection of nodes and edges. When we are talking about direction or directed or undirected, it has to do with a graph that has a direction. If the graph does not have a direction, it simply means it's an undirected graph. There is a compare network A and compare network B. The distance between these two networks has a value. If the value or the weight is not assigned, simply means it's also unweighted. Therefore, this simply means that the example we have from before is a typical example of undirected and unweighted graph. As you can see, there is no direction of where we have to move from A to B or C to B. We can move, as it is now, we can move from any direction. We can move from D to B, D to C, then D to C to A, or A to C to B. Then there is no weight assigned to that value. Another example that we know also, not part two, is undirected and weighted. Undirected and weighted. For example, looking at the graph we have on the board, we have A, B, C, D. So it is undirected. I think we will assign the value here 5, 3, 4, and 7. So because there is a line that is placed on the edges, it is now a weighted graph. So the weight between the two networks, network A and network C, is 5. Between network A and network B is 4. Between network B and D is 7. So from that example, you can see that that is an undirected graph, but it's weighted. Another example that we can have is, as we have A, B, C, D, and E. So this graph, 3, 7, 5, 10, 7, 1, and 3. You can see it is also undirected and weighted graph. In another example, we can also see here the top category of it is directed and unweighted graph. So we say directed and unweighted graph. So in this case, it means that the graph is directed, but it does not have weights on the edges. So for example, we have something like this: A, B, C, C, then D. So we have this. So direction, from direction now, simply means that we can move from B to A, but cannot move from A to B. We can also move from B to D, but we cannot move from D to B. We can move from D to C, likewise we can move from A to C. We cannot move from C to A. That means that there is possibility of moving from, that if you want to get to C, you can either move from B to A, then C, or B to D, then C. We cannot move otherwise. using the example that we had, second example we had again, that we saw A, B, C, D, E. So you can see from move to E. So for the diagram you can see, we can move from B to A, we can also move from C to A. We cannot move from A to any other direction. We can move from, so if you want to get to A, you can either move from D, you can move from D to A. If it's D, this one was B to C. I think we are moving from D to A. You can either be D to B to A or D to C to A. Or I can also move from D to C to B to A. You can see that. So in this case, we have those roads to pass. The last example we have is, the fourth example is directed and weighted drag. We have directed and weighted drag. Directed and weighted drag. So in that case, pass something like this: A, B, C, D. Five, three, seven, four, three. So you can see this, the graph is both directed and weighted. Other example we might see is A to B to C, B and D. So the area is 5, 7, 10, 15, 11, 1, 4. So this graph is also both directed and weighted. So for example, you are moving from D to A, which is D to B to A, which is D to B is 4, then B to A is 5, that means you have 9 for the weight. But in the case of here, we are moving from D to A, so we say D to C, then C to A. D to C is 15, and C to A is 7, that is the weight of 22. And also say move from D to B and B to A, that is 4 and by giving us 9. In the next video, we'll be considering more of this example. Please, in case you are not subscribed to our channel, please click on the subscription button, that's the red button down the video. And in case you want to get notifications about new videos on our channel, click on the bell beside the subscription button, and please do well to give our video a thumbs up, and don't forget to drop your lovely comments. See you in our next video. Thank you for watching.